you guys, and good luck no matter what. Now just calm down for a moment because this is the most important holiday of the year. And this is our day. I always knew that our day would come. Before I introduce the members of the group, I'd like to say that I believe tonight is the mysterious night that two members of the Ramones are actually in the audience. I think tonight's the night. They were supposed to come and see at least one of our shows. If they're here right now, hello to them. I'm so glad that they could stop by because they're the guests of our drummer. Meanwhile, I'd like to introduce to you Ray White on guitar and cowbell and vocals. Patrick O Hearn on bass. Terry Ten Bozzio on drums, Leather X and Jay Whip, Eddie Jobson on keyboards, violin, and Randomonium, and of course, in the red dress with the sequins and the things, the Monsignor, the lovely Bianca, on vocals and keyboards. For those of you who are unfamiliar to this particular presentation, my name is Frank. And this is a song about my feet. Stupid disease, chromatrosis, and well, we should. The less regular folks who might wear a tennis shoe or an occasional python know this exquisite little inconvenience by the name of Stinkfoot. That's right. You know, my python boot was too tight. Couldn't get it off last night. We went by. I finally got it off and my girlfriend cried. You got Stinkfoot. Stinkfoot, darling. Your stinking foot puts the hurts on my nerves. Stinkfoot, Stinkfoot, I ain't lying. Can you rinse it off? Do you suffer all this cotton? Here, Fido, here, Fido, bring the slippers, little puppy. Give me the slippers, Fido.
Fido!
All right, where's the slippers? I said, where's the slippers? Look, where are the slippers? For those of you who don't understand dog talk. The dog is saying to me, and you won't believe this, this dog just said to me, Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ! I was so stoned I couldn't keep him in my mouth. And so verily I said unto the dog, I said, hey, Fido, hey, this is New York, you can be punished a lot. You should have brought the slippers while you had a chance, because now I have to hurt you quite a bit. Where's that whip? Mistakes. The first one was the poodle. There is a poodle candidate right here. The first mistake was the poodle. The reason the poodle was a mistake. Hey, how you doing, Bobby? Hi, Marcia. Everybody from New Jersey right there in the front, aren't they so cute? Right there, stand up. It's my brother Bob, a former Marine. Stand up, Bobby. Ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Zappa. Hey! Want to sit in? Alright. Now, the reason the poodle was a mistake was because he originally wanted it to be a schnauzer. Isn't that right, Bobby? You have an education. Tell me, is this true? Okay. But he fucked up, you know? Everybody makes mistakes. God made three of them. The first one was a poodle. I'm going to explain it to you very carefully. This is Frenchie, the Exhibit A type poodle. Now, God made two other mistakes. Mistake number two was called man, and mistake number three was called woo man. Now, the woo man looked at the poodle with lust in her heart. And then she looked at the man and she knew that the man was a sucker. He always was, he always will be. That's the way God made it. She looked at the man and she said, hey boy, why don't you go get a job? You know, a job. And so he got a job. What did he know? He didn't know what a job was. It was in the old days. Jobs weren't so bad. He got a job. He even got paid. He got paid old time money for it. And he brought the old money back to the woo man, and she took the money away from the man, and she stomped out of the Garden of Eden and went to a hardware store. When she got to the hardware store, she got herself a pair of clippers, some scissors, and a pair of zircon-encrusted tweezers. I'm gonna say amen to it. That's right! Boy, if I was Reverend Ike, I'd be in business right now. Look here, she went to work on the poodle. She cleaned this son of a bitch right up. Cleaned off his back so it wouldn't be too hot, you know. She figured that the schnauzer had all that, so she cleaned off his back, pruned his thorax, his medulla, his gula, even trimmed all this area right near Queens, right around here, all the way to the Bronx. And here, in this horribly filthy part that we know today as the East Village, she cleaned that up. Right, all around St. Mark's Place. Really? This is the balloon farm right here. Remember that? Here's the Garrick Theater, right there. Oh, look. Look at this here, stuck next to his toenail. It's Bleaker Bob's old record store. Then she took the poodle, and she drooled a little bit while she was doing this because, you know, she had this lust in her heart. She set the poodle up over on the side like this. And she went over and she sat on his face. Do it, but while she was sitting on the poodle's face, this is true, she looked deep into his little dog-type eyes and said these words.
Yeah.
song that deals with the delicate subject of higher education. This song also happens to be cut one, side one of our new LP, which is entitled Zoot Allures. Yes, this is a commercial for the album, because those son of a bitches at Warner Brothers won't do anything to sell it, so I'm going to sell it myself. This album is now available. I want you to go out and buy it. And after you buy it, send a letter to Warner Brothers and tell them to go doot, 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 doot. Meanwhile, the name of the song is You're Gonna Wind Up Working in a Gas Station. Let me see your thumb. slime and rot and rats and snot and vomit on the floor. In 1500, a soldier's man holds his spears by the iron door. Knives and spikes and guns and the lance on every tool of pain. And a sinister midget with a bucket and a mop where the blood goes down the drain. And it stinks so bad, the storm's been choking.
Been chirping.
All right.
In the night.
as all green and buzzing is the dream of this band. Who are all these people that is not around here? Are they crazy?
Tell me, tell me. Titties and I.
What about the beer then?
Three cans this tall.
Even her boots.
Would I lie to you?
Shit, you must have been hungry.
Yeah, this is true.
Don't they pay you good for what you do?
No, I can't complain when the checks come through.
Well, I want my Chrissy and I want my beer, and you just spit it back up.
Listen.
Do you hear? Do you hear?
Just blow it out your ass, motorcycle man. I mean, I am the devil. Do you understand? Just what will you give me for your titties and beer? I suppose you noticed this little contract here.
You're goddamn right, you something don't call
me that.
That's about the only reason I learned right for. Give me that paper, bet your ass I'll sign. Cause I need a beer and it's titty squeezing time.
Man, you can't fool me. You ain't that bad. I mean, you should have seen some of the souls I've had. There were Newhouse Nixon and Agnew too. Both of those suckers were worse than you.
Well, let's make a deal if you think that's true. I mean, you're the devil now. What you gonna do?
You wanna make a deal with me?
Sure, of course I wanna make a deal with you.
First.
Now, let me put it to you this way. You can have my soul. It's a mean little sucker about 1,000 years old. And once you get it, you can't give it back. You gotta keep it forever, and that's a natural fact.
I gotta keep it.
That's right, you have to keep it. You have to keep it all of your very own. You have to keep it right there on your dresser. You gotta keep my soul forever.
Hold on.
I'm not gonna wash it or nothing.
I don't
use any deodorant on it. You have to keep my soul for it.
No, wait a minute. All those funny things
going
in my hair.
I want my beer. I want beer. I want more beer. I want beer. I want hockey. I want beer and football. I want beer and weenies.
Wait.
I want beer and potato chips. I want titties. I want titties and beer. I want titties. More titties. Bigger titties. More beer. I want more hockey. More. I want a t-shirt like this. To fall in love on Halloween as any other night in the year. In fact, in most instances, it's better. It gives you a little extra something, you know, the candy corn. This song is for people who are about to fall in love on Halloween. Probably about 15 to 20% of you. No, maybe more. This looks like a very luxury audience tonight. The name of this song is Black Napkins. How would you guys feel if I actually tuned up? I can't stand the sound of this circle on Zap.
Your mama told me. dates.
Stand up and just twist a little bit in there. Just right by their chair. You can sit back down really fast when you're done so that nobody knows that you actually stood up. And I won't even look. We're going to give you one more chance.
Thank you.
they don't care. I rub my chimney, chin, chin, and see ya. My, my, my. What sort of thing might this lady get high from? The $400 bill didn't matter no more. When her sister got naked and laid on the floor, she said, Dinah-Moe might win a bet, but you could use a little balls if I wasn't drunk yet. Just because the sun's gonna piss in the sky, don't listen to me, so I would give her a try. So I pulled my hair, got her legs up in the air, and I asked her if she had any cooties in there.
What do you mean, cooties? No cooties on me!
Bianca and Mr. Southern. Good night.